Hi, welcome to Hands That Rock Crochet with Mickey Annie. Learn to make this gorgeous belt buckle phone case cover for your Samsung S9 and S9 Plus. Gather your materials and let's go on a crochet journey. Protect your phone from any scratch or damage by making this textured phone case. Make a slip knot and chain 9 chain stitches plus 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 plus 1, 10. Measure your chain stitch and make sure that it's the right size for your phone. Double crochet into the second chain space from the hook and make a double crochet in each all the way down for a total of 9 double crochets. Into the last space, make another double crochet and one more double crochet, so you have 3 double crochets into that chain space to turn your work, and we're going to carry and work back. If you want, you can work your tails in to the project, because I like to do that, and less work for me to do later. Into the next space, I make a double crochet, and the next one, a double crochet, and into the next one, Now you have your last chain space there. You need to make 2 more double crochets. 1 and 2. You can snip the remaining tails later. This is your right and this is your wrong side. Normally you would slip stitch in there, but what you need to do is yarn over and go round that loop to make a front post, double crochet front post. You've joined your work, you've joined it. Okay, yarn over, make front post, double crochet into the next or around the next double crochet as 2,
third one front post and the fourth one. So you have four front post double crochets, yarn over and go around from the back and make a back post into the next double crochet. That's one back post, second back post into the next, the third one back post double crochet, and into the fourth one back post double crochet, yarn over, go front post double crochet one into the next one front post double crochet two, the next one front post double crochet three, the next one front post double crochet four. Now we make a back post double crochet one, back post two, double crochet, back post double crochet three, and back post double crochet four, and over. You have four back post. Okay, you've made 1, 2, 3, 4 back post. So now you make into each of the next four, you make front post double crochet, one in each, for a total of four. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. Okay, and now we're gonna start all the way around again. If you want to, you can put a yarn marker, but I don't really need to use a yarn marker because we're going all the way around and we can follow the pattern. So here we start again with front post double crochet one, two front post, three and four. Now we make back post into each four double crochets, one, two. So for this pattern, you need to know how to make your front post and back post double crochets. And then you can come back and make your mobile phone cover. Front post. Two. Three and four. If you make this in a continuous round, your mobile phone cover is going to have a nice finishing edge. But if you join as you go along each round, you're going to have a spiral that goes wavy, which doesn't really look very nice. That's four. Now we go back to our front post double crochet one, front post double crochet two, front post three, and front post four. Here we have front post for the other side. One, two, three, four. Front post double crochet. Now make a back post. Crochet back post, one, two, double crochet, three, four, double crochets. With your work, you will notice that you have 1, 2, 3, 4 ridges. So when you go around and you have 4 on that side, you've complete the first stage of the pattern. Make a front post, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we make back post, double crochet into the next 4 double crochets, yarn over, front post, double crochet, front post, double crochet, front post, double crochet, 1, 2, 3, one more front post, double crochet. If it's getting a bit difficult to locate your rounds, to know when to start the next round, I know I'm coming to the other side, so you can attach a yarn marker or any thing at all that will help you to, let's see, so you know you're there. So before we carry on, we need to check to make sure that this will fit our Samsung X9 phone. Check all the way around and then carry on working right to the top. Four. Now we go to front post. One, two, three, four, chain to back post, one, double crochet, back post, double crochet, two, no, back post, double crochet, three, and back post, double crochet, four. This is our beginning, and we're going to make a back post, as you can see wherever you have the ridges. So carry on and make 4 rounds for the next stage. Now we get into the beginning of the next round, which is here. You can see your marker, yarn over. We've done 1, 2, 3, 4 rounds. So we're going to change the pattern now, and instead of back, we're going to make front post double crochet here. One, next one, front post double crochet. Move your marker up if you want to use a marker. Front post double crochet 3 and front post double crochet into the fourth double crochet. Now change your pattern and make a back post. One back post double crochet, the back post double crochet, back post double crochet. So by now you should be able to see the pattern. I'm going to cut this yarn tail here. This was the beginning yarn tail. Just snip it so that's out of the way. Okay, now you can see you've got your basket with front, back post, front post, back post. So we're going to carry on and build our phone case cover, just like so, for however long. We've got 4 rounds for each, and then we change again. So you can do that off camera. So we'll carry on building our phone case and making our basket weave pattern. 4 rounds for each, and then when you've nearly measure as you go along, and when you've nearly covered your phone, you can use this phone case cover for any phone at all, iPhone, iPhone X, anything. Just have your right measurement and then you build on the height of the stitch. Okay, so see you soon. Okay, the next round of 4 lots instead of front post here, we're going to do back post double crochet, back post. 1 double crochet, back post, 2 double crochet, back post, 3 and back post double crochet, 4 yarn over, make a front post, 1 front post double crochet, front post double crochet. Carry on for the next 4 rows. That's my stitch mark out there. Now I will make 1 more round, so 4 rows, and then we'll carry on. After 6 locks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I've got the perfect size. Half double crochet all the way around for a total of 20 half double crochet stitches. Slip stitch, skip that and slip stitch. Cut your yarn, then weave in your yarn tail. We need to make the flap. This is going to be the back. Attach your yarn however you like to attach your yarn. And make half double crochet. One, two, three, four and five. Slip stitch and turn your work. Chain one. This is my yarn tail and I'm going to work over my yarn tail. Half double crochet, one, two, three, four, five, chain one and turn. One, two, three, four, five, five, chain one, turn, and carry on making your five rows of half double crochets. Make a knot and leave a long tail for sewing in your pull through. You've got a long tail. I've already attached my sewing needle. Now, this is gonna be the back. Make sure it's centered. Fold this one, two on itself, that's two, and then put your hand through and sew down or stitch down. Because you're using the same type of yarn,
you don't have to be too too religious about it, because it's not supposed to show through. Okay, carry on and tuck this down. Make sure when you're tucking down, you don't go, and you put your needle through, you don't go to the other side. There, you only need the back of your case or phone cover. So hence, I've got my finger in between, and make sure that you're quite safe when using and tucking down or sewing down. So I'm gonna go this way as well. Secure it very well, because I don't want it to come off. That's it. And the edges needs to be. Now, once you think you've done enough and it's quite secured, you need to weave in the tail and then cut your yarn. I'm gonna weave in into the few stitches there. It's nice and secured. And then to snip, I'm gonna pass this through to and pull it from the inside. And then turn. I'm going to weave in a bit for extra security. And then make a knot. And then snip. That's it. And it looks something like this. So for added security, I'm going to also tag this part. Using the same yarn. Your phone case is ready and good to go. That's your handle, or you can put it around a belt. If you want to put it, if you want to put it around your belt, pretend your you've got your belt on, and then you put it on this way, the buckle, your belt, and that's it, you're good to go. Anytime your phone rings, you can just pick it out of there. Thank you so much for tuning in into this channel. Thank you for your love and support. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Hope you enjoy making your crochet case for your Samsung S9 Plus or S9. We hope to see you soon on Ask the Real Crochet for more fun tutorials. If you've not subscribed yet, do not miss out on any more tutorials. Just click on the subscribe button and don't forget to click the bell for more notifications. We hope you have a good crochet journey. See you soon in the next video. Bye bye.